Turning now to the latest in the fight against the coronavirus. Walmart and Sam's Club pharmacies began giving out the COVID-19 vaccine today. KNBC9's Brian Johnson has the best tips on how you can hopefully get a spot in line.
This is the triumphant photo Dave and Ann Vandervoort captured after getting their COVID-19 vaccinations.
We got in and they were really good and like, we were like, yeah, we're in. It was exciting.
At Walmart, they were among the first to sign up for a spot in line. Doing that on day one was no easy feat.
Looking for a place to get your vaccine is like trying to buy concert tickets. You just keep looking and keep looking and keep looking, you know, until you find something or they're gone.
The Lee's Summit couple searched for hours.
I just kept checking back and I thought, well, nothing's really happening.
Dave secured a spot only after expanding his search to stores within 100 miles.
That's when they started popping up, you know, Butler, Warrensburg, St. Joe.
They say friends drove 2 hours to Brookfield, Missouri to get the vaccine.
Keep trying.
The key is being willing to drive and checking all the apps, Walmart, Sam's Club, and Navigator. They say it means the world to get vaccinated.
Relieved, sort of, getting baby steps to get on the other side of this big mess we're kind of in, you know.
Walmart will add more times and locations as vaccine supplies increase.
Keep trying to get your vaccine. It's wonderful. It's a wonderful feeling. And just don't give up. Keep at it. You'll get there.
Brian Johnson, KNBC 9 News.
So many families are trying so hard right now to get those vaccines, we know. And at Sam's Club, no membership is required to get your vaccine. Walmart plans to partner with other organizations to expand access to the vaccine through off-site clinics, they say, in the future. The Johnson County Health Department is partnering with organizations and businesses to better serve people wanting to get the vaccine. Heart to Heart International will serve as a portal for people who want to volunteer during the vaccination effort. It is also partnering with Hy-Vee and Auburn Pharmacy to offer vaccinations to people at several independent living centers in Johnson County. And we are compiling your vaccine questions and answers to them at KNBC.com. You can find specific information for your state or your county, including who qualifies for a vaccine and how you can sign up. It is all at KNBC.com/vaccine. This week, the CDC started recommending that you wear two masks and that second mask, especially if you're going out in a crowded area. Hospitals say that they are getting a whole lot of questions about how long you should wear a mask before you throw it away and put on a new one. Now, we talked with the folks at St. Luke's Hospital. Health experts there say it's really a judgment call, but they recommend changing it daily or, in some cases, hourly.
We tell people that if the mask is moist, you should dispose of it and wear a new one. If you go in to the grocery and you've got a mask and you don't touch it, then, you know, potentially you can wear it again in that day. It's kind of a judgment call.
She says reusable cloth masks should be washed daily after each wearing. And if there is ever any question about the mask, just throw it away. She says it's pretty cheap insurance to keep you healthy and protected. We are tracking the spread of the coronavirus tonight. 175 new cases of COVID-19 and 2 related deaths reported in Kansas City, Missouri. The rolling average of new hospitalizations is up slightly to 110. The Centers for Disease Control says America's schools can fully reopen if they do it safely. Everybody will still have to wear masks at school, frequently wash their hands, and practice social distancing. The CDC is also pushing for smaller classes and better ventilation. These are guidelines, they're not rules, and that's why they probably will be applied differently in different places.
It's helpful to have it all in one place, but I think districts will have the challenge of figuring out how to do all those things successfully.
The CDC says educators should have priority to get vaccinated, but it is not ordering teachers to get the shots. The bitterly cold weather is forcing some schools to shift to remote learning, and this week schools in Liberty sat empty for 3 days, but learning didn't stop. Liberty is one of many school districts that's now turning to online learning. Students tell us virtual snow days are a little bit different. There are positives and there are negatives.
That's definitely a positive. I feel like I can work at my own pace. And I can get stuff done pretty efficiently.
There's a lot of students that I've talked to that say it's very hard to stay motivated.
Now there is a bonus with remote learning. Students will not have to make up for snow days at the end of the year.